Okay, in this calculus tutorial, I'm going to show you guys three examples on how to linearize a function at some value. So here we have the first one, f of x is equal to e to the 3x, and we are going to linearize it at a equals 0, the x value 0. So let me just remind you guys the formula. It's really just the equation of the tangent line. First, we write down l of x for the linearized function, and this is going to be f at that a value, and then we add the derivative there, and then we are going to multiply by x minus a. So if you take a look right here, this is really like saying y minus y1 is equal to m times x minus x1, except for we move the y1, right, minus y1 to the right hand side, which is this y value here, f of a. The derivative is the slope of the tangent line, and then x minus a, which is the x1. So algebra calculus. So let's get this to work. Firstly, of course, let's just compute the f of a. So we know that f of a is 0. That's just going to be e to the 3 times 0. It's just e to the 0, and that will just be equal to 1. Done. Then we are going to get the derivative, so f prime of x. Remember, the derivative of e to the something is just that thing. So it's like e to the box. Yeah. So first, we just repeat that. E to the 3x, then use the chain rule, multiply by the derivative of 3x, which is a 3, so multiply by 3 like that. And that's it for the derivative, and I will just write down f prime of x is really just 3 times e to the 3x power, plugging 0, so we have f prime of 0 equals 3 e to the 3 times 0's power, like this. This is just 1, multiply by 3, we get 3. And then we have all the ingredients to plug in. So ladies and gentlemen, L of x is just equal to f of a, which is 1. We add the derivative, which is 3, times x minus a, which is 0. Just like that. Finally, we'll just rewrite it in a nice way. L of x equals 3 times x is 3x. 3 times 0 doesn't matter. And then we have the 1, so plus 1. So L of x equals 3x plus 1, and we're done. Okay, here we are going to linearize the cube root of x at a equals 8. So here's the formula. Let's go ahead and plug in 8 into the function first. So f of 8, that's just the cube root of 8. That's just equal to 2, because 2 times 2 times 2 equals 8. Done for that. Now, get the derivative. So let's actually write this as the 1/3 power first. So rewrite f of x being x to the 1/3 power, and then use the power rule. So the derivative will be, we first put the power to the front and then minus 1. So we have 1 over 3 x to the 1/3 minus 1. We get negative 2/3. And then perhaps we can rewrite this a little bit, put this down to the bottom. So we have 1 over 3 x to the positive 2/3 power. But you see this little denominator 3 becomes the cube root. So this becomes 1 over 3, and then we have the cube root of x squared, like so. And then I'm plugging 8 into the x. So f prime of 8 is 1 over 3 times the cube root. And in fact, you can put a square on the outside, it will be easier that way. If you put a square inside with the x, it's for a nice look. But when you do computation, do the cube root of a first, and then the square on the outside. They are really the same, right? And then if you work that out, you get 1 over 3, cube root of a is 2, so multiply by 2 square, and just write this out for you guys. And that's 4 times 3 is 12 on the bottom. Yay! Now plugging everything. So L of x equals f of a is 2 plus the derivative there, 1 over 12 times x minus a, which is 8. All right, and then just work this out. So this is 2 plus 1 over 12x, and then 1 over 12 times the 8 is just multiply and then reduce by 4, so 2 over 3, so yeah, minus 2 over 3, and then 2 minus 2 over 3, get the common denominator. I just show you guys all the work right here. So that's 6, 6 minus that, yeah? So this becomes 1 over 12x, and then plus 4 over 3. Just like that. So I am just going to box this for the final answer. L of x is equal to that. Okay, here we are going to linearize this function cosine of 2x at a value pi over 6. Here's the formula, so let's go ahead and get to work. F of pi over 6, so this is cosine of 2 times pi over 6. In another word, cosine of pi over 3. Do we remember our trig values? What's cosine of pi over 3? Pi over 3 is 60 degrees, refer to a special right triangle at 60 degrees, so it's like this. Here 60 degrees and that's 30 degrees. The ratio of the sides, the smaller side is 1, this longer side is square root of 3, hypotenuse is 2. So by looking at this angle, which is pi over 3, and do the cosine, which is adjacent over hypotenuse, we get 1 half. Pretty nice answer. Alright, then we are going to just go ahead and do the derivative. So f prime of x, take the derivative cosine of a box, yeah? So the derivative cosine is negative sine. And then the box stays the same, so just 2x inside. Then we multiply by the derivative inside, which is a 2, like that. So f prime of x is just negative 2 sine of 2x. And then plug in pi over 6 again. So let's see what we have. So f prime of pi over 6 equals negative 2 times sine of 2 times pi over 6. So again, this is pi over 3, so let's see. This time is this over that. So the value that we're looking at is negative 2 times square root of 3 over 2. And then this 2 and that 2 cancel. So the derivative there is negative square root of 3, right? Negative square root of 3. Now plug into the formula. So we have L of x equals f of a, which is 1 half, plus the derivative there, which is negative square root of 3, and then times x minus a, which is pi over 6. It's kind of bizarre because this is irrational, that's also irrational, but we're just going to put them in a nice way, that's all. So what I mean by that is, I'm just going to first distribute, so we have 1 half, this times that is minus square root of 3, and then x on the outside. And then when we multiply this and that, do not reduce, because we can't. 3 is inside of the square root, this is not. Negative times negative, that's plus. And I'll just put down plus square root of 3, pi on the outside, and then over 6, like this. Well, maybe they want to learn calculus too, look at that. Square root of 3 over 6 and then pi like this. Pi is just a number, all right? Lastly, I'll just move this here. Usually, we like to have the y equals mx plus b form, right? So that's why. So the slope is this, negative square root of 3 times x. And then these are the numbers, so 1 over 2 plus square root of 3 over 6 pi. Done. Just like that.